Entering and formatting data is central to everything you do in Excel. So in this video, I'm going to cover some data entry and formatting shortcuts and give you some tips on formats to avoid. We can enter text, dates, or numbers into cells. Simply select the cell that you want to enter the data in and start typing. Press Enter to complete the entry and move down one cell, or you can press Tab to move across to the next column. Let's create a table. We're going to have a column header for dates, and then I'm going to enter my first date, which is January 1, 2019, and I'll press Enter. You can see it's been formatted as a date. Now I enter my dates day, month, year. If yours are month, day, year, then you'd enter them accordingly. You can also enter dates with a hyphen separator. Notice that it automatically picks up the formatting from the cell above, but if I enter a date that's significantly different, it will maintain the formatting that I typed in. We'll talk more about formatting in a moment. If we look at the formula bar, you can see that despite the cell showing 1-Jan-19, the underlying date is shown as 1/01/2019. What we see in the cell is the formatted value, whereas the formula bar shows the underlying value that Excel uses in its calculations. In column B, I'll enter the regions. We'll say East, North, and West. And in column C, we'll enter the value 10, 15, and 20. Notice that the text in column B is aligned to the left, and the dates and the values are aligned to the right. This is the default format, and I recommend you maintain this standard in your Excel work. So you can see that entering data is as easy as choosing a cell and typing in it. You can also enter data in multiple cells at one time. So select the cells that you want the data entered into, make your entry, and hold down Control and press Enter to enter them all in one go. You can edit a cell via the formula bar, and then I can use my arrow keys and the Home and End key to navigate to the position that I want to modify. Delete will delete the value, and then I can type in my new entry and press Tab or Enter to complete it. Another way to edit a cell is to press the F2 key. You can see the cell itself is now in edit mode, and I can change this to South, for example. Alternatively, I can double click a cell to go into edit mode and press Delete and type in a new value. Now that we have some data in our worksheet, let's look at some formatting options we have available. And there are loads of tools I can use. You'll find them on the Home tab of the ribbon. All I need to do is select the cell or cells that I want formatted. So let's format these headers, and I can give them an underline. Let's make them bold. We'll change the fill color to this blue, and let's change the font color to white. I can also change the font style. There's lots to choose from. And if you know the name of the font style, you can type it in to filter the list, and when you find it, press Enter. I can change the font size. I can even type in an exact size here, or I can use the buttons here to make it smaller or larger. We can align the font height or the fonts left and right or center. We can indent them. Remove the indentation. If we have a lot of text in a cell, for example, let's change this to business regions, we can wrap the text and then it will fit wrapped into the cell. If you have a heading like I have here and I want to center it across those cells, we can choose Merge and Center. You can see it's now merged across cells A, B, and C. Although I don't recommend that you ever use merge cells, so let me undo that. Instead, a better way to align your data across the cells is to open the Format Cells dialog box. Either click on this launch icon here or press Control 1. Then on the Alignment tab, Horizontal Center Across Selection. I'll click OK. When you use this technique, you can still choose cell B1, whereas when you have the data merged across those cells, you can no longer choose B1 or C1. You can only choose all three cells, and this can become problematic for formatting and other editing, but also when you're writing formulas, it's best to just avoid merge and center. When we're formatting numbers, there's lots of options. Some of the more common ones are available here in the number format dialog. If I select a cell containing a date, you can see it's shown me that it's formatted as a date. I can click on the drop down and choose from different formats. For example, I could choose a long date. Or I could go into the Format Cells dialog box, and on the Number tab of the ribbon, there are lots of pre-built date formats that I can choose from. I just select the format that I want and click OK. Now, just going back into the Format Cells dialog box, I'll press Ctrl 1 this time. You can see there are lots of tabs. On each tab, there are loads of tools, some of which are included on the Home tab, and some that you'll only find in this dialog box. For example, on the Font tab, we've got Strike Through and Superscript and Subscript, which aren't available on the Home tab. We've got the border options. So here I can choose a border style. I can choose a color. Let's go with that color and the dashed line. I can choose to outline the cell. I can also choose inside. So if I had more than one cell selected, I could format both inside and at the outline. I can choose specific borders to remove. And we even have strike through both directions. So there's lots of options here. I'm just going to go back to none. We have our fill colors, there's patterns to choose from, and lots of colors. And we'll cover the protection options in a separate tutorial. On the number tab, there are lots of different categories. We've got time, percentage, fraction, and so on. We even have custom formats where you can create your own format, enter it in there, and click OK. I'm going to cancel out of there. I'll leave you to explore the Format Cells dialog box options available after the lesson. Now, one of the things we can do that's not so obvious is we can format part of a cell. So, for example, I can select business in here. We get the tooltip dialog box up here where I can select a different font. I can change the size, and I can just change the size of business. I can make it bold, italic, change the font color. So for example, let's make business red and bold. And I'll press enter. So you can see I've only partially formatted that cell. I can copy formats, selecting the cell that I want to copy the format from. Click the Format Painter. You can see it has the marching ants, and now when I click on another cell, that format has been applied. If I want to apply that format to multiple cells, if they're contiguous, I can just left click and drag. Or if they're not contiguous, I can double click and I can apply the formatting to non-contiguous cells. When I'm done with my formatting, press Escape to clear the marching ants and the clipboard. There are also built-in styles up here on the Home tab in Cell Styles. You can see we've got Good, Bad, and Neutral. We've got Data and Models. So if you're building a model, you might like to format some cells that are for your users to insert their data as the input style. If you've got links, then you have perhaps the link cell. And calculations would be for cells that contain formulas. We've also got titles and headings and themed cell styles. You can create your own cell style. It will inherit the formatting based on the cell you have selected when you go into this dialog. Give your style a name. This is the formatting that's applied, but you can make changes to it. Go into the Format dialog box and make changes accordingly. When you're happy, click OK, and then click OK to save your style. It will then be available in the cell styles. If you want to remove formatting, you can go to the Home tab and then over on the eraser icon, clear formats. It's not going to clear the formatting in this particular cell because it's formatted inside of the cell as opposed to the entire cell. But I could remove formatting from all of these cells by clicking the drop down and then clear formats. Now, if you make a mistake entering data or applying formatting or almost any action, you can undo it with the shortcut keys Ctrl Z or go up to the Quick Access toolbar and click the Undo icon. You can see it's reapplied my formatting. If you undo an action in error, you can redo it by clicking the Redo button or using the keyboard shortcuts Ctrl Y or F4 depending on the previous action. F4 doesn't always work, but the Redo button will. So you can see my formatting is gone again. You can undo and redo multiple actions in one go by clicking on the drop-down. Select the actions you want to undo. It will undo everything up to the action you select. Unfortunately, you can't pick and choose actions. It's just all of the ones up to the point you select. And at the bottom, you can see I'm going to undo 5 actions. The same applies to the redo. I haven't got anything to redo right now, so I don't have a drop down, but that will also be available for you. It's important to note that this list is all actions you've taken in all open Excel workbooks, not just the current workbook that you're in. Okay, that wraps up entering and formatting data. Take some time to familiarize yourself with the menus and options before moving on to the next lesson.